I'm Liviu Popa-Simil. Let me start first by introducing myself and give you some details about my life and work. I am a senior scientist specialized in nuclear engineering and physics. My major is in nuclear reactor physics and engineering with emphasis on cutting-edge technologies. I'm the executive director of Los Alamos Academy of Sciences, LAAS, the president of LABM LLC, a private R&D company located in Los Alamos, New Mexico. Now, I live in Los Alamos, New Mexico, USA. I was born in Bucharest, Romania, which is now a member of the European Union. I have lived, studied, worked in Bucharest, capital city of Romania. I have started the nearby kindergarten, and I follow the classes of the Central Elementary School. I was part of the first generation of the College of Informatics High School, where I have learned computers programming. I have obtained the PhD title with the distinction magna cum laude from the University of Bucharest and the Institute of Atomic Physics with a dissertation work in material and material loss characterization using nuclear methods. I started my career as a prototype test pilot engineer in automotive industry, working to promote novel physics technologies and inventions in the machine building industry. I did many vehicle tests, having on board hot discoveries of the technology from that days. I was the initiator and among the founders of a robotic division, a nuclear physics division in several car companies, and laser application groups, and more. I had a great mentors as engineer Johan Juvelka in the picture and engineer Peter Libowski, who taught me great lessons of life and engineering. About the same time, I have joined a special research group for the study of singular events, which gave me a more complex image of nature. After a few years in machine building industry, I moved to Romania's National Institute for Nuclear Physics and Engineering, and I worked in the accelerators application division, performing researches in advanced nuclear fields, materials, radioactive labeling, environment, ion beam based analysis, and so on. I have taught physics as a part-time professor at the Polytechnic Institute of Bucharest for more than 5 years. After 1990, I worked part-time as a scientific counselor for the Ministry of Industries, ending up in only a few months as the editor of the newspaper Counselor, a spin-off of that time. Soon, I gave up my teaching and editorial position for a part-time position of technical manager with private company active in process control, taking part in the local industry modernization. On the side of singular phenomena study, I got very interesting revelation of the hidden aspects of nature being most often put outside the common domain of knowledge, which was taught in school, being forced to use my own brain and strive to understand more. And I consider this exposure essential to my future scientific evolution. I have to admit that several times I have been looking to understand the nuclear aspects related to UFO encounters, my main efforts being related to developing portable instruments to measure the environmental radioactivity after an incident and technologies able to separate between terrestrial originated events and other events. That activity was a long series of failures, or so-called partial successes, showing me how unprepared we at the planetary level were, and we still are, to appropriately deal with such a potential event. This involvement motivated me to conceive and coordinate the build-up of better nuclear spectrometers able to serve the industrial applications needs and the environmental fast response measurements. The incident related in the chart were hot subject under debate, failing outside the common knowledge of human error without finding a reasonable explanation inside the actual realm of science, and many aware that in spite of belief that we know a lot, much more remained to be learned. I had the honor and pleasure to meet the distinguished Professor Roy Cayonel since 1978, being my fast breeder nuclear reactors dissertation work coordinator, and later one of my mentors. He mentored me and initiated me in his concept of direct nuclear energy conservation, classified by that time, allowing me to study and improve them seamlessly. We have carefully prepared a stack of microthermocouples that was accidentally burned out and transformed into a microlayer capacitor that delivers more energy than previously predicted. That idea for introducing heterogeneous nanostructures to further improve the cell energy conversion efficiency appeared. So, a kind of metamaterial appeared and was further developed into a unitary set of applications for better, safer, and cleaner nuclear power. My personal belief is that one solution to the future problems rests in the application of the nanotechnologies in nuclear materials to improve the energy production, because with enough energy, all other resources may be obtained. Here is a direct nuclear energy conversion into electricity cell, similar with that I have started my research work, and I have developed some improvements to it until I have realized that thanks to a cyclotron failed experiment, the changes that have to be made in order to improve it. That experiment attempted to measure the volume distribution of a beam power deposition and predict material modification due to the temperature field variation. I have been honored to do my PhD dissertation work under the coordination of Dr. Dorel Bali, a very experimental physicist in neutron and X-ray science. Since my second year of college, I was attending Professor Popescu's plasma classes, and later he, together with Dr. Javid Musa, were my coordination for the master science dissertation work in uranium enrichment using lasers, plasma jets, later becoming my friend and mentors. I recall with pleasure and admiration his talks about dark matter, ether and neutrons, being by many years in advance of his generation, puzzling many of his colleagues and me too. By that time, I had hard time understanding what he said, and as one used to say, if one is by one step in front of his peers, is considered to be a genius. But if he is with two or more steps in front, is considered to be a crackpot by his peers. Even now, I am not convinced that I fully understood him, and I am admiring his work. Working in the automotive research group, I had the pleasure and honor to have engineer Peter Livovsky as my supervisor, mentor and friend. Following his advice, I started introducing aggressively nuclear technologies into industry, and I met Dr. Petru Mihai Racolza, who was a team lead for similar application group and my friend and advisor for more than 30 years. At LANL, I had the honor to be advised by Dr. Gordon Jarvinen and Professor Dr. Michael Nastasi, whom I appreciate so much their friendship. In 2001, I came to US, and since 2002, I'm in Los Alamos. Between 2002 and 2005, I worked for LANL's environmental division on transuranic risk characterization, and later, by 2004, for the material science division in AFCI, Advanced Fuel Cycle Initiative Program. My several first months at LANL have not been so easy or so pleasant, because I was put under high pressure to overpass the experimental measurements on true waste drums in order to provide reason that based on so-called acceptable knowledge, to pass them as good to go and ship them to Whip Carlsbad to be buried underground, and the LANL's team to be praised by DOE for it. At the beginning, I had an avoidance attitude. But in few months, when the pressure grew, I have been forced to take a firm stand up and to explain LANL managers involved in that their forceful management practice is prone to breach the nuclear quality standards I stood for during my past. I have explained why it is wrong, prone to failure, and I have been warned by the management about the possibility of having an underground nuclear accident with serious implications. It was the end of the year 2002, when I did that, and I was transferred to the science application division to do work that I consider my help there. My 20-year prediction to the management were overpassed by reality, and in less than 12 years, that accident happened, putting out of use for several years or more the WIP waste insulation pilot plant facility in Carlsbad, New Mexico, with a price tag in billions, way above my several million prediction. In fact, a February 2014 truck fire underground and a Valentine's Day radiation leak shut down WIP, and elevated levels of plutonium and americium were detected outside the nuclear waste repository. See the upper picture. They like to call it a bad luck, and this is true if we talk in terms of Russian roulette, but in reality, this is another example where nature is not so forgiving to human errors or wishful thinking based. But my rest of period with LANL was interesting, and challenging, developing various methods to improve RTR. MAS stands for real-time radiography. Up to the technological limit, to remove the bottleneck from the visual examination, making several invention disclosures with LANL and NSA, and starting to build and apply them.
Yeah.
But surprise, soon after that, by the spring of 2004, my work and my colleagues' work was thrashed out by DOE's waste directorate that externalized the cleanup project to some external companies very unprepared for the job, but very well connected to Washington, D.C. That DOE decision triggered a fallback in time of more than 10 years, and the old paper-based procedure replaced a newly developed web and computer application, reducing the accountability. In spite of interesting things I have achieved, I consider this two-year period we planned in environmental division a waste of time and a distraction from my subject of interest in nanotechnology's application in nuclear fuels in order to create an environmentally friendly nuclear power. My AFCI, Advanced Nuclear Fuel Cycle Initiative, working period was short because in that year DOE defunded the program and transferred it to INEL, Idaho National Laboratory, and some work I started in nitrate and metal oxide fields remained unfinished. During 2005, I worked as an invited scientist with the Decision Application, Radiation Transport and Risk Management Division of LANL, doing computer simulation using MCMPX, a Monte Carlo code, for the novel nuclear reactor structures I have conceived. During 2006, I acted as a consultant for various local companies active in energy applications, advising them in matters related to solar energy, catalytic, flameless burning, diffusion, thermoelectric generators, etc. And in 2007, I founded LAVM LLC in order to better promote the nanotechnologies applications. By 2010, I was among the founders of Los Alamos Academy of Science, a company involved in local economic development and education betterment, and since then I have been its executive director. Here, in Los Alamos, I had more exposure to the needs of the mankind, and I have started to develop and disclose my knowledge in a more organized manner, having the stimulus for many renowned scientists I will mention, like Professor Magna Stassi, Dr. Gordon Jarvinen, Dr. Dave Poston, and more. I greatly appreciate their friendship and support. Over 25 years, I have worked across a wide variety of cutting-edge domains, including nuclear fuels, various nuclear applications, transmutations, accelerator-based ion beam analysis, computers, environmental applications, and more. For me, it was always a challenging task to produce better fuels. As you see, the kind of fuel bundle in the upper right side, and to improve their better behavior inside the nuclear reactor, see below the spectacular luminescence due to cooling water scintillation inside the test nuclear reactor's active zone. On the other side, spooky action at a distance and frontiers in quantum environment as entanglement, teleportation, and quantum active assemblies are of great interest for me. Also, trying to have a better understanding of these phenomena, which up to yesterday were called singular, and use them in novel energy schemes like fusion transmutation battery. On the other hand, developing fast elemental analysis for environment is of tremendous importance because that might help us develop a healthy environment on a prosperous planet. Up to now, I hold 4 patents to Romanian and 2 United States patents, and I have applied for several more US patents that are pending. I worked in a high technological environment, being familiar with many nuclear devices, operation and design, and I know how difficult it is to drive a nuclear reactor in the actual technological conditions, and that is why I stand for developing in an accelerated manner novel materials to bring higher harmony inside the nuclear power reactors. On this idea, I have communicated several times with DOE and disclosed it in many communication and patent applications. I have served as chair and co-chair in many conferences and meetings. I was among the organizer of a conference about low-energy nuclear reactors called ILNRS-12, where I have contributed with my explanation to this very challenging, newly considered phenomena. Since 1985, I have written and published more than 200 peer-reviewed papers. I wrote 5 book chapters and several e-books, and I have received many acknowledgments and prizes. Among them, I'll mention the Romanian Prize for Excellence, prize that was awarded to other famous Romanians as Nadia Comăneci, Mircea Tudor, Dorin Prunaru, and many more. My research topics of interest include the application of nanotechnologies in nuclear power, terahertz detection and imaging, multimodal individual transportation system, some medical and environmental applications. My research approach is a multidimensional, multi-scale, that starts from the phenomena at the nuclear level, an atomic level, nano and meso level, up to the final micro device and its application. During this research effort, heterogeneity by the design concept appeared as a necessity and a condition to improve the harmony at the deepest level of nuclear reaction in interaction with materials or the energetic device. The chart gives an overall image of the path from the nuclear reaction to perfect nuclear fuel burning by the breed-and-burn process in advanced reactors, able to assure only using fission the continuous energy supply of the planet for the next 10,000 years, being one of the energy solutions of the future. But there is more to this story. I investigated low-energy nuclear reactions, LENER, kinetic subjects since 1980s, witnessing various strange, hard to explain, inside classical physics phenomena. Most of them are related to abnormal behavior of hydrogen isotopes in materials. I acted as principal investigator in many cases, as well as a team member in others, and I have gained extensive experience in this area. Now, as I briefly introduce myself, it's my pleasure to inform you what we might expect if we introduce nanotechnologies, nuclear materials, and that will help you find the meaning of all these pictures on the ebook cover. Advanced nanoengineer materials provides development and improvement of the structural materials capable of operating at high temperatures, resistant to radiation damage, corrosion, environmental degradation. Development of advanced ceramics and coatings for fuels. Development of materials to contain nuclear waste and radioactive elements used in nuclear power plants. Reduces the need for uranium mining and processing. Radiation detector materials and more based on harmony between materials and nuclear agent, achieving structures that directly separate fission and transmutation product from the nuclear fuel. Convert the nuclear energy directly in electricity, guide radiation in nanostructures for shielding and concentration or modulation, makes free of damage, self-repairing structural materials, and more. All these are due to a better understanding of the nuclear domain and achieving a high level of harmony. Engineered nano-meso nuclear materials bring harmony in nuclear power-related devices. Nano-micro-engineered structures may bring a surge in performances and safety of energy-related devices by improving harmony between nuclear processes and devices. This is briefly the main content of the presentation. A more abstract subject about the harmony in engineering and science, an introduction to novel nanostructures applied in nuclear power and their potential outcomes. There are five distinct structures that are dealing with agents present in fission nuclear reactor and a specific structure that may facilitate fusion inside solid-state devices able to create quantum active environments. The chapters are Harmony in Science and Engineering, New Nuclear Structures and Applications, Micro-Heterostructures and Fission Product, Nano-Heterostructures and Knock-on Electrons. Nano-beaded structures, transmutation and recoils, micro-nano quasi-amorphous and radiation damage. Micro-nano patterned structures, radiation guiding, quantum active environment, nano-heterostructures, and new engineered devices and their applications. Nuclear power is over 70 years old. And after its explosive debut and a period of nuclear weapons development, the nuclear energy applications appeared and was smoothly developed over the time, but is still in its infancy. The actual nuclear structures are far from being developed in harmony with the complex nuclear processes inside, acting at nanoscale and picosecond, and that is due to the fundamental understanding of the processes inside correlation with the human and its mission. Famous thinkers formulating the relationship between knowledge and understanding, and here you are what famous scientists of the time concluded in a dialogue in December 1925 at Paul's Ehrenfest residence from Leiden, Holland, where Albert Einstein is credited for saying, "Any fool can know. The point is to understand." And Niels Bohr responded, "The important thing is not to stop questioning." And Zeto continued on a fundamental aspect of the newborn domain as quantum mechanics, hard for Einstein to understand and acknowledge, pointing at the strange effects as spooky action at the distance, in his terms. Something now we used to call quantum non-locality or quantum teleportation and entanglement, and new theory of relativity. There was no string theory that time, just the beginning of the understanding of the multidimensionality of space-time. Yes. Later, on 1975, Mrs. Suzanne K. Langer concluded, if we have new knowledge, we must get a whole new world of questions. And this is a very true statement, fundamental for any knowledge mastering process.